Good morning, dear children. Welcome you all to our online class. So in our previous class, we were discussing about spherical mirrors, concave mirror and convex mirror. And with the help of an activity, we learned that image formed by a concave mirror is real and inverted, whereas image formed by a convex mirror is erect and virtual. Today, let us see image formed by a convex lens. Have you ever observed your grandparents or any other elderly person wearing spectacles? In fact, young people also wear spectacles, right? So what are these spectacles? The glasses which are there in the spectacles. What are those glasses are called? So these are nothing but lens. So it is a lens and not a mirror. A lens is a piece of transparent medium bound by two curved surfaces. Lenses allow light to pass through them. You must have used a magnifying glass to focus sunlight on a sheet of paper and which starts burning after some time. The spectacles people wear are made of lenses. So here we will learn about two basic lenses, that is convex and concave. A lens which is thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges is called a convex lens. And a lens which is thinner in the middle and thicker at the edges is a concave lens. Take a convex lens or magnifying glass. Put it in the path of sun rays. Place a sheet of paper. Adjust the distance between the lens and the paper till you get a bright spot on the paper. Hold the lens and the paper. Does the paper begin to burn? A convex lens is able to converge sunlight at a point. If the point lies on a piece of paper, the paper starts burning. This implies that a convex lens is a converging lens. The light generally falling on it, therefore it is called a converging lens. Now let us understand image formed by a convex lens. If a convex lens is placed very close to an object like a printed sheet, then the print appears magnified, virtual and erect. Due to this reason, in this case the convex lens is called a magnifying glass or a simple microscope. But if the object well illuminated like a tree or a candle is far away from the lens, then its image can be taken on a screen on the other side of the lens. This image is inverted and real. Fix a convex lens on the table in the vertical position. Put the candle in front of the lens and light it. Take the white sheet of paper and hold it on the other side of the lens. Look if you could see an image of the candle flame. Move the white sheet forward or backward with respect to the position of the lens until you obtain a sharp and clear image of the flame. Now shift the candle a little towards the lens and again obtain the image of the candle flame on the white sheet. Repeat this step 3 to 4 times. The image formed is generally real and inverted. Depending on the distance between the lens and the object, the image will be diminished, enlarged, or of the same size as the object. When the object is very close to the lens, the image formed is virtual, erect, and enlarged. Image formed by a concave lens is always virtual, erect, and diminished. Did you ever observe a rainbow in the sky? Just after the rain, it looks like a big arc and it consists of many colors. It consists of colors which included violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. You might have seen that when you blow soap bubbles, they appear colorful, right? Similarly, when light is reflected from the surface of a compact disc, you see many colors. On the basis of these experiences, could we say that the sunlight is a mixture of different colors? Let us find out. Now let us perform an activity. For that, take a glass prism. Allow a ray of light to pass through the prism on white sheet of paper. Observe that the prism splits the light into 7 different colors. Sunlight is considered as white light. This means that the white light consists of 7 colors. Can we mix this color to get white light? Let us find out with the help of an activity. Take a circular cardboard disc of about 10 cm diameter. Divide this disc into 7 segments. Paint the 7 rainbow colors on these segments. You can also paste colored papers on these segments. Make a small hole at the center of the disc. Fix the disc loosely on the tip of a refill of a ball pen. Ensure that the disc rotates freely. Rotate the disc in the daylight. When the disc is rotated fast, the colors get mixed together and the disc appears to be whitish. Such a disc is popularly known as Newton's disc. So what we have learned today? We have learned that convex lens form a real and inverted image, and concave lens forms erect, virtual, and smaller images. So children, I have attached the URL video and notes. All of you please copy the notes in your notebook, and all of you please attend the test paper and post it. Okay, see you in the next class. Bye.